My name is Key!
Best show ever did. That's how we do it every year. Mehran Khaghani.
Oh, Keith! Hi, buddy!
This is how we do it.
Oh, do you see how I'm ready?
All right, so there's no way you can do a mic check with Mehran.
No.
I'll tell you that one.
No, I'll just break it. I'm sorry.
But no, we paid extra for limiters. We have five limiters plugged into each other.
Is that a thing?
Shorted out my microwave. How much? By the way.
Yeah.
How long were we hanging out before the show started?
Like a solid hour and a half, right?
Do we like each other?
We love each other.
Yes.
I love you. Yeah. Oh, I love you.
How dare you?
I knew it. $5.
How dare you tweet out? I'm gonna get Keith to kiss me at the end. Let's get it out of the way because we got to get fucking real right now.
Did it feel good?
No.
Oh,
it's disgusting.
On,
it's so gay.
That's not true.
I just wish there was a better word for kissing a man.
When I kiss a girl, I'm always like, girl lips.
Yeah, your lips are salty.
Mostly because of balls, right? Because it's all the nut sweat that's accumulated over the years. It's like the Dead Sea, right? But that's...
I wouldn't have done that if I knew you were gay.
What? Oh, no. I mean, I'm not like practicing gay. You know what I mean? I'm just religiously gay.
But I'm just like, going to...
My
just
mother
gonna,
was gay.
I'm going to use alcohol to just clean up real quick.
No. It's a disinfectant. My dog took a poop once on the stage of a burlesque show.
Right.
That was about to have any number of G-strings rolling
around. By the way, I hope we kissed during the camera's blind spot. What if they saw it?
Nothing would happen. Nothing would happen. It's 2016, Keith, right? Is it or is it not 2016?
We got Trump for president.
We sure do. I can't wait for a Trump
president. Are you excited? Like, what if he makes it?
There's
like,
absolutely no way he'll
There's
make
one
it.
Part of you, just between us.
Yeah.
One in the make it and see what happens.
Is there any part of me that wants him to win?
Yeah.
Is there any part of me that wants him to win? There's a mischief maker in me, right? Like, there's a devil in me.
Like maybe you're at brunch and everybody's being a little too liberal and you're like, let's see what happens.
But I don't think he'll change that. He'll probably make them worse. He'll galvanize them.
Right.
Right. So that's
Good
a
point.
Problem.
Yeah.
Right. Like he's not going to take away the people who piss me off.
Right.
He's just going to make them rally, which I can't imagine.
So what so the kiss happens because I see on Twitter this guy says we're doing this show.
Are you really justifying the kiss right
now? No, I'm bringing it back to tell you the whole story. Uh-huh. On Twitter he goes, I'm very excited for My Name is Keith tonight. We're going head to head.
Head to head.
Because we were supposed to do this earlier and I had the flu. And he goes, you know what? I'm practicing for it. You can't fuck with me. I'm the best drinker that's ever been.
I'm one of the best drinkers there's ever been.
Right. So I go, but it's not a, I swear it's not a challenge. And you know what Mehran tells me after a Keith and the Girls show?
What did I tell you?
I talked to somebody that was on your show.
Yeah.
And you fake it. You don't drink. You get them drunk. And I'm like, who is it? And I don't want to think, like, I'm 42 years old. I don't.
Are you older than me?
So I don't. I guess
that's outrageous.
Unless you just say that to
you
any
look
age.
No, I mean it. You look younger.
You're an angel. What age?
Yeah. I'm 40 itself.
40. All right. You saved this time.
Yeah.
And then we'll get to the height and weight.
Uh huh.
So first, yeah. So you go. Well, a guest was on. Said you faked, and I'm like, and shame on me. My mind automatically goes to a woman.
Uh huh. Like you think a woman?
It must be. It must be a woman would say that
because men don't talk to me.
and then you go, no, it's a guy. And I go, fuck, I don't even know, man. Who was on? So Jason Burks tested, like,
I don't even know who that
are you
is.
Trying to are you and so I give you a lot of names and you go, I don't know them. And then I go, okay. And I named a guy told Mehran that I cheat on this show.
Yeah.
Drinking. And
a
I
guy
went
did?
To you said a guy.
I told
did.
You that?
Yeah.
Okay.
So are you taking it back that's a woman?
I don't know.
Because you would save us time. You said a man. And I named every man. Uh-huh. And you said, after I said, if I get it right, will you tell me?
Yeah.
You said yes.
Yeah.
You were sober.
Yeah.
To be clear. And.
During like the 5 minutes. Of my
and
life.
You, but I caught you.
Yeah.
And I went through every man. And then I realized I went through every man. Whoever fucking weirdo asshole is talking to you is a liar. They weren't even here.
Keith, this
they
person
weren't
said,
even here.
He
you
like,
pussy. You heard, think no? Wait a second. I want to do a Mehran Khaghani impression.
Oh, I love that.
I stand up for what's right. Like it's more my
no.
What I'm saying, not how
you're doing
I say it.
This is exactly how I sound.
I stand up for what's right. I will not be bullied. I've been picked on, and I realized how to become a man or a person or a human. And yes, I will name name nouns. Who's the person that will you name that person's name? Oh no, it's too much.
Oh my God! No, you know snitches get stitches. I'm not dropping a dime on
you.
Anyone.
You don't have to, but I want you to know
that
this person's a weird liar.
Okay,
and there's not much worse in this world.
No, I'll take that to heart too.
You don't have to.
Moving forward in my life, I'll know that Keith Malley thinks this person is a weird liar.
Yes. Yeah.
That's in my that is in my Rolodex of shit I know.
Oh, 1 second. Was it Danny Hatch?
No.
Okay. Then I covered every male.
In the world.
In the world. In the world. There was nobody on this show that would have.
They just said that I'm gonna be coaxed into drinking a lot. And that you are going to take like little baby sips.
Was it your boyfriend?
No. How does my boyfriend know how you drink?
Maybe he's nervous. Like,
maybe the two of you have something going on.
Well, it doesn't matter.
Just tell me the truth.
Obviously, I kiss anybody.
Are you fucking my man?
How long have you been with your boyfriend?
5 years.
Five years?
Yeah.
Have you been faithful the whole time?
Yeah.
Okay. When weren't you?
Where are we drawing the line?
Okay, let's start with sex. Let's start with sex.
Sex, none.
Okay. So what kind of flirting are you doing?
Oh, I'll flirt. I'm the makeup bandit. I love kissing people at parties.
Really?
We just made out.
Tongue kissing, though.
Yeah, I'll make out with anything.
Will you literally, and I think this is the difference, have you ever sucked the tongue? Literally sucking it, like it's a dick.
Yeah, like nectar.
Will you do that? Will you do that?
There is nectar on a tongue.
Will you do that?
With someone else?
Yes.
If the chemistry is right, he and I have an agreement.
That could have saved us time.
What do you mean? Do you want me to suck your tongue?
No, Jesus Christ. I mean... Hold on. I need another disinfectant. Again, not homophobic.
Yeah, I know you're not. I know you're not homophobic.
I wish I was, because that would make me clear. Mm.
I know. And I know that I am like a siren. I'm irresistible. I know I am.
You have a hip t-shirt and then a
lightning, and then the sparkly jacket, and then a certain control, a certain mastery over booze, right? I know. I know I can do these things.
I got to know what the agreement is, because I don't know about these agreements.
So in my world, right?
Okay. Your world or you and your guy? Because
Me and my guy. Okay. Absolutely. It's something that he and I understand. I found out after we got together that he's been jacking it to twink porn his whole life.
Where one guy's a kid kind of and the other person's a big animal.
No. Just twink in general. Like he is attracted to small-bodied, lean, hairless.
But how do you know he's been jacking off to it in front of the person live?
No. To porn. This is the porn he likes.
So who's the other? So it's two twinks.
He might watch two twinks. He might watch authoritarian porn where like there's
somebody in charge.
Somebody in charge of the twink. And in fact, I think that's very specifically his poison.
Okay, so that's my point.
Right.
I knew I was
right.
Yeah,
no, no. Your
There's
point
one
is,
twink.
Your point is, I hear
valid.
You.
Thank
I agree
you.
With you.
Thank you.
And but I'm never going to give him that, right? I see.
How'd you find out? You walk in on it?
No, it's a conversation you have. Have you and your wife ever talked about what porn you guys like?
Sure, but yeah, we'll watch it together sometimes.
Yeah.
But you had a conversation and like he freely said, I'm into twinks.
No,
and then
I'm just observing what it is that he's into.
But how do you just observe it? Like what you're
like, as in like what turns you on? And it's like another video with like a submissive.
But you see where I'm going with this. Does it make you nervous?
No.
No, you can't be what he comes to when you're not there.
I am.
That does not make you nervous at all.
Not even remotely. Like, he loves me.
I see what you're saying, because I masturbate to only not Irish women.
And you're married to an Irish lady. So why wouldn't, so here's the thing.
But you know what I mean?
Yeah, but I don't, so there's a line in The English Patient, Keith.
Okay, go on.
Where
I yelled from the audience, boring!
Oh, it's such a good movie!
Oh,
what is wrong with
right.
it? I will watch it with you.
No,
we'll
you
get
won't.
Shit-faced.
When I say
and when Ofra Haza sings, I'm going to embrace you. I'm going to hold you close to my bosom.
That's how bad it was when I forget references to a movie, but I know I saw it.
So Kay is dying.
Oh no, Catherine don't do that.
Is dying.
I don't care.
In a cave.
Great.
And she's filleting a flashlight while she scribbles in her journal.
Okay, she has a flashlight in her mouth to see in the desert.
No, but
probably.
She's also like, whoa. She's doing that. That's what she's doing.
I don't believe it.
It's what she's doing. And then she writes, we die rich with fruits we have tasted.
Okay.
And I want my partner to taste as many fruits.
Right, but you'd like to be the fruit. You're a vegetable.
I am the fruit on occasion.
Right. No, I mean, you're the fruit.
Right, but do you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, I mean,
is sex good?
With my partner?
Yeah.
Is it the best sex I've ever
of
had?
Of course.
It's not the best
is
sex
that,
I've
is
ever
that
had.
Is that nervous? You've been with him for 5 years. Is that nerve-wracking? Does it make
no!
you concerned?
No, he's my life partner. He doesn't have to be the best sex I ever had. The best sex I ever had.
But not even that. Are you concerned? We'll go back to that. Are you concerned that, like, I have to make it the best sex?
No!
Really?
No,
that
I can
is so
compartmentalize.
Mature.
I can compartmentalize.
I can't. If I found out I wasn't the best sex my wife ever had,
yeah.
I would read books and go online and find that and make myself the best sex ever.
Yeah, this is such an interesting thing because I think like gay people, we got at some point like an ox's yoke. We were presented with the idea of partnership, right? Because we weren't allowed marriage. We couldn't think of each other as husbands,
sure.
What have you.
So, how old were you when you first knew you were gay?
15.
Okay.
Continue. 15 for sure, 13 jacking it.
Okay.
Probably 11 jacking it.
Was it to twinks?
No, it was to muscle men. It was to big, burly muscle men.
Down to your soul.
Yeah.
You couldn't agree.
What do you mean?
I feel a herpes sore just popped up. That's
no,
not possible,
no,
right? That's
no.
impossible.
No, I'm right. I'm,
I agree.
I'm no, antiviral. I'm... Do you think that this is hospitable to anything? Do you think that anything here like would ever settle and then mm-hmm. nest and take root? It wouldn't happen. I scare viruses. I don't. I've used 3 condoms in my life. HIV negative. Hundreds of partners.
Okay. No, I believe.
I mean, it's true.
Right. Sorry. But what were you saying? You took that off your perfect angle, by the way. You think you still look good?
Great.
There you go.
The muscle men, him and twinks. I'm right. not partnership.
Right.
Partnership was the thing. And I feel shot, by the way.
Shot, by the way.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Of course.
And so, cheers.
Big ears.
So I worry. Eventually, yeah, you're going to resent. You're not having the best sex you ever had. If this is the only
I'm allowed to have sex outside of my relationship.
So how? So explain that.
I feel very strongly.
No. Just what are the rules, period?
If the right chemistry presents itself, chase it.
And he can too.
Yeah.
Could he break up with you without heartache?
Why break up with me?
Well, I don't get it.
If he found someone that he loved better, I would insist that he break up with
But me. That would be, right. But that would be extreme to be clear, right?
Like because we love each other incredibly.
Can
like,
you,
we are very,
can
very
you
good
fuck somebody and keep fucking them? Can you fuck them after 3 weeks?
Would he be allowed to continue fucking someone?
Yes.
Yeah, sure.
Really?
Yeah.
Has he ever had an outside relationship you were concerned about?
No.
Have you?
No.
To him?
No.
Okay. Has he ever had an outside relationship, period?
I don't know. Neither one of us has deviated
okay.
yet. We haven't had to.
Okay. So that explains it.
But, no. I would, again, chemistry, Keith.
Yes.
Within the realm of chemistry.
Right.
If he were on the train and there was some little piece of fishy twink,
mm-hmm,
some mm-hmm. live, hairless,
right.
darling boy.
And he just had to ejaculate right there. You'd respect it.
No.
Still
and he was looking
home.
At my man like, I want to ride that. Like, and my man's girth certificate is tremendous. It's really. And he's like, I want.
Girth certificate?
Yes.
He has a big penis.
He has a thick wang.
How long?
It's not gonna, it's a good length.
I know, we measure ourselves. Did we measure the other person?
I've never measured him.
Cause I measured every clitoris
I
was with.
I know that he is my first long-term partner who's made my jaw sore. I know that's uncomfortable.
Isn't that funny? You have to go, well, it's uncomfortable because you can't talk
right.
No,
it's uncomfortable to talk.
But isn't it funny? Like you go to your doctor and you're like, no, you fix this,
it's
but
not
it's TMJ. Good news.
Yeah, it's good news.
All right.
I love him. And I want him to have as many things in this life as possible that make him happy.
Is he nervous how much you drink?
Yes. Ooh, you wrote that down. I told you about that. He's nervous with how, like, in general, like, I will throw myself against shrapnel. You know what I mean? Like, I will...
You try to... Okay, so let me take this one step at a time, because you do like to put yourself in bad situations, and I think it's funny how you justify it.
What do you mean?
Let me explain. So first, let's start with when you started drinking.
I'm all ears.
How old?
Probably 19.
19 years old. Where do you get it? I know that's dumb. I didn't have friends at 19.
Like gay bars and college.
Well, I guess I did. I did.
College and gay bars.
My first apartment, people brought the beer in. I hated it. I poured it down the sink, and I lied to my two best friends.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, I've always been an extrovert, and then you add this, like, go-go juice.
Right, there's no need.
Well, no. I mean, I was like, I'm an actual superhero. Like, right. It was a great feeling.
You liked it right away.
I liked it
right away. What was your first drink?
That worked, probably wine.
Okay.
Like cheap Carlo Rossi, you know what I mean? Wine.
Would they sell it at Rite Aid or a little better than that?
Massachusetts doesn't sell liquor.
Okay.
In convenience stores. So it was like liquor store. The cheapest, biggest jug of wine was probably the first thing I got drunk on. Oh, no. I take that back completely.
I'm not offended.
No. A Korean girl I went to high school with, Jen Sa. Was mad at her family, and she poured me an 8-ounce glass of Goldschlager,
and I drank. Oh shit!
Yeah, she poured.
Say
me
that one more time.
An 8-ounce glass of Goldschlager. I drank a big old. I chugged Goldschlager, and I passed out in a Friendly's toilet. That was the first time I drank.
Did she pour it in Friendly's or you went out
after? No. And then she was like, let's go to Friendly's. And I'm like, I love fried anything because Iranian food isn't fried.
Have you talked to her since? Ever?
Oh, no. She's like a happy Christian, has kids.
But you see her on Facebook. Wouldn't it be funny to write, hey, remember this?
Hey, I'm really good at this now.
Yeah, but even I don't drink. Like, I'm everything you find disgusting, and I wouldn't drink Goldschlager again.
I honestly think it was like it was revenge against her father that she was having me drink her liquor.
But
his liquor.
Do you know that that is real gold in there?
Oh, I do. Yeah. I do know that there are actual flakes of gold. And
you would think people would just sift it.
No,
or sieve it.
It was the richest that Friendly's toilet ever looked.
It does come back up, right?
Oh, yeah. I threw up the world that day. And then I remember like sort of an unseasonably formal shoe at Friendly's kicking my hand from under the stall.
Uh-huh.
Like, are you awake? And then somehow I got away with it. I don't know how I got
But not in the way where like nowadays you see a shoe under the stall. It's good news.
It is. It's invariably a Republican who wants my attention and he'll get it.
Now, what did I write down? 18 dumping. You got me drunk, which I think you just explained, if that doesn't make sense to anybody else. 19-year-old gay bar.
Yeah, I would go to gay bars very early. Because back in the day, there wasn't online. So if I wanted to find Tail or even...
Let's say it was 19-year-old bar. Mm-hmm. Period. Mm-hmm. Not a gay bar. Yeah. A regular bar.
Yeah.
I don't want to say the normal bar that Jesus wanted, but a bar.
Uh-huh.
Your parents let you, I couldn't have that.
Well, parents aren't part of the, after 18, parents aren't.
Where were you at again?
Huh?
Where do you live at?
Lexington, Massachusetts is.
And your parents would let you just go to a bar. That's
no,
crazy.
No, they wouldn't let me go to a bar.
I would sneak out and live
life. I was barely
life.
Living at home at the time. Like, if I was living at home, I was working and staying with friends in the city.
Why would they let you?
Why would my friends let me stay with them? Because I'm fabulous. I mean,
why would your parents let you? What's going on with your parents?
Like to come home from college and be allowed to stay at home?
So that's what it is?
Only
you're
only,
19
and only after my freshman
you're
year.
You're 19 you're 19 in college, you come back.
Yeah.
And now you're an adult and you can go around.
And now I'm biking around the city.
All right. I got confused what 19 means. No, I really did.
I was 19. It was after my freshman year in college. And
I've seen 19-year-olds. Oh, it's not looking pretty.
What do you mean? I was a pretty 19-year-old.
No.
Have you
ever
seen pictures of me from when I was young?
I'm going to sound like a person on retarded Facebook, but these 19-year-olds. Am I wrong, guys?
Have you seen me at 19?
No.
I was.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, showstopper.
What's your height?
6'1".
Put your phone down.
No, I'm showing
you. I get your point. I don't want to say
it. All right, fine.
I don't trust you. How tall are you now?
6'1".
6'1".
What's You're not going to ask me my weight. I'm never going to tell you my weight.
What's your weight?
No, it's like a wash of denim. It's like, it's not even a...
I'm going to start guessing.
Okay, go ahead.
Stand up.
Fuck. Keith.
Okay. He's sucking in.
I'm not.
You're not. Can't ask you to lift your shirt up. You're a guest. I see your zipper's down, so that could mean something.
Oh, you fucker, Keith.
240.
Nope. Oh, way, way, way above 240. At 240, I look like you.
282.
Pretty close.
Fuck yeah. What is it?
No, I'm there's no
I'm pretty close to no. 282. 297. Oh, tell your friends.
Jesus Christ. 297. No, leave me alone. How about that? Okay. How about, what do you weigh?
206.
And how tall are you?
I'm disgusted by it. I'm 17 feet, 3 inches.
Who gave you a complex about how what you look like? Because you look good.
Oh, nobody did. It comes and goes. Thank you.
You kiss good.
I do, right?
Yeah.
That gets rid of the last question. This is going to be a fun show.
Oh, this is like...
Where's this getting started? You know what? I saw Metallica recently, and they
started... Really?
And they started the show with like, hey, before we get started... I'm like, that's a trick! You're already getting started! We're just getting started.
Yeah, I have a lot about Metallica.
This is very funny. Oh, yeah?
Yeah. My brother loved them.
Where'd he go?
For school.
Is he dead?
No. Okay. He's dead to me.
What happened?
I used to get beat up a lot.
Right, and he didn't help you.
No,
he and he encouraged.
No, he was the one who beat me.
That's the worst.
He was
man.
10 years older than me. So when he was 21, I was 11.
He's 21. You were 11. So 10 years difference. Mm-hmm. So we have you at 40.
He started beating me at 3.
And he's 50.
Yeah.
It would be fun to fucking show up and you just push him into garbage.
No, I mean I could kill him now. Like,
but wouldn't it be funny? Push him in the
to
garbage
kill him?
And go. No,
oh, I've had
no, but I'm being serious. Yeah. I'm being serious. Like maybe, of course, you thought awful thoughts. Like you dream and jack off and kill him.
No, I don't jack off and kill him.
Okay, I was trying to make you said
I know,
not
I know,
so disgusting.
I know it's lighter. I know that you make it lighter with semen.
But just that's me, and that's Keith. But you just show up to where he's at, whatever city. Push him in the garbage.
Yeah.
And you go, you weren't nice. And then you get back on your plane and go home. And he goes, was that my brother? How fucking great would that be?
That's so easy. No.
You think you can do that?
No, you clearly have never been abused. I'm sorry, you played that tape of that guy who wept. Keith played me a few previous episodes.
Keith McNally. Only have... My family is the most poorest family. Your family, Keith, was poor.
And I think he did that just to, like, make me mad.
My family was super poor. My uncle only had 2 trailers. Meanwhile, his parents are a lawyer.
They toss him a grand a month, which...
Yeah.
Like, in my life...
You don't get it!
I have maybe squeezed a grand out of my family in my adult life. Maybe.
Right.
In my adult life.
I was.
Yeah. And that's like when I was like dead in a ditch raving.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like that, maybe I got a couple hundred bucks to get me out of it.
You would hate to do it. Yeah. You don't know how they're the worst. My uncle has 2 trailers and you and fuck you! Yeah! And you're like,
yeah,
what
he really
the
did
fuck?
Yell like that.
He said, do they just call it? What did you call it? Wasn't therapy. What was the word you used?
I said you need behavioral health support.
He really does. I never behavioral heard that term support. Before, but yeah. He really does. Mm-hmm. All right. Mehran Khaghani.
I love you, Keith.
You love video games?
I do play
what,
video
what
games.
What kind of games?
Computer games.
How would we meet online?
Invariably strategy games. You wouldn't like
them.
Oh, I mean,
no.
Really
those
nerdy.
Are the worst.
I play Civilization. I play...
You have to build shit. Build
XCOM.
A house. Build a house. Do you get killed in your village because you're interior decorating your house too much?
Oh, no.
I don't know these games.
No. Civilization is a really beautiful game. I bet you would love it.
I won't.
No, you might.
There's a reason it didn't catch on
you
to
might.
Me
yet. You might. Because you don't play computer games. You might play like Xboxy, PS3. Yeah. You might play console games.
Right.
But I bet you don't play PC games.
I played console-like games on PC before there were consoles.
Like what?
First-person shooters.
Okay, FPSs are fun. And they're good.
They're good.
They're good.
And heterosexuality is good. I can acknowledge it.
But don't you want something with like greater depth? And
no, because then there's so many keys that might not work.
Oh, no, no. It's not keys. It's still point and click. Oh, okay. It's still point and click. Civilization is very much a point and click
game. Oh, that's too slow. I don't have time for slow. Life
is slow.
Life
is
slow.
It is a very slow game.
Life is
slow. It's like playing Monopoly with yourself. That part is true.
There you go.
That part is true.
Well, if it's masturbating, I get it.
Do you get it?
How often do you masturbate?
Conversation I had with a friend just yesterday.
I called you on the phone prepping him yesterday.
He did. Keith was like, you jacking it?
I'm going to ask you three questions. Don't be offended by these.
How often do I masturbate? Some days, let's say three times. And sometimes 3 days with none.
Does it make you nervous when you masturbate three times, like in a day, going, why aren't I talking to my man?
No, why would it make me nervous?
Because I'm not fucking my man. Is he away?
No.
No?
Again,
am I not like, making sense?
No. You make perfect sense. But
am I making hetero sense?
It's this idea that like we mate with someone who's supposed to fulfill our every need.
Right.
Do you know what I mean?
But he lives with you, right?
Yeah. We live together.
Interesting.
And he jacks it to sort of his private flavor.
Yeah, there's some.
Do you not
it
ever,
does not bother.
How about you?
Yeah, I masturbate day in, day out. I fuck my wife day out, day in.
Good for you.
But thank you. But that's what I was getting at. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate
good
it.
Good for you. No, I mean it.
Seriously.
I also mean it.
It is fun to hear. Thank you very much. But it doesn't, you weren't nervous for a second. We said when he's masturbating to twinks.
Why would I be nervous?
Because you're not one.
That's the whole point. Do you fantasize about things that aren't your wife? And I know she listens.
Honest to God, no. If she... she doesn't listen to this. These were disgusting.
Oh, I know.
If she... Like, if she was masturbating to, I don't know, whatever the opposite of me is, I think it would concern me. It would.
Really?
Of course it would. In the back of my head, I'd be like, I'd even know what it'd be. But this is the opposite of me.
But is sex the foundation of your relationship?
No.
No.
But sex is fucking very, very important to any relationship. There's communication. And then let's think what else there is. Sex.
Sex is a form of communication.
The best form. You're inside delivering it.
Oh, that is so sweet.
But honestly, I wasn't trying to be funny. I thought
I'm right there.
A third or fourth thing, but I can't. There's communication and there's sex. What else is there?
Companionship. There's shared lifestyle.
Oh, I think that's communication.
Oh, no.
I think that's all communication.
No. You might not have to communicate in order to just know that there's another person dying in the same room as you.
What does that mean?
That companionship.
Oh, like literally if somebody is literally dying. Is your boyfriend dying?
Let's say an apocalypse happened right outside of these windows, right? And you and I are here, right? I would be your companion, whether or not we communicated.
Right? But you're not my partner in life.
Of course I'm not. But my point is that I would still be this person who is next to you for the walk of your life, whether or not we communicate.
I follow you. Okay, so let's agree. You have communication, companionship, and sex.
Intimacy and sex.
Right. When I say sex, I mean good sex. So yeah. I would think that was intimacy, but okay.
No, good sex can oftentimes be very much not at all intimate.
It kind of is. I get what you're saying. You love rough sex. Rough sex is fucking intimate.
Is it intimate?
Isn't it?
No.
What do you mean?
It's not intimate necessarily.
What's the roughest you get?
What is the roughest? I mean, some mild.
What's the roughest?
Some mild hitting.
Where?
About the face.
Do it. About the face.
Yeah.
Do it right here.
If I'm being slapped, right?
Where?
In the face.
Okay.
Right.
Holy shit!
And then you, how do you slap the other person in the face?
Oh no! I'm the one who's getting slapped.
You will not slap the person.
I mean, I'll slap the person if they've lost their fucking minds. I'll beat them to death. But like
you like to be slapped.
On rare occasions.
Well, I'm not coming up to you on the street.
No, 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 but it's on rare occasion.
Do you say it? Do you say slap me? Like somebody goes, oh, kiss me.
So I hired a hooker once just to slap
me. You can speed this up.
Yeah, here it is. I hired a hooker just to slap me, and he did it wrong.
How do you mean?
He like rang my ear.
Oh, fuck.
Yes, so it didn't work out. It wasn't supposed to be.
And then you're like,
But that doesn't mean that I'm not interested in the dynamic.
Right. Does your boyfriend know you hired a hooker?
Once upon a long time. Yeah. Yes.
Are we talking about the same hooker?
What do you mean?
Huh?
What do you mean?
You.
I didn't hire a hooker since we've been together. This is before.
That's
we
what
were
I mean.
Together.
Okay. Okay.
But if I were to go outside of the marriage, I would much rather be with a hooker. And I would much rather him be with a hooker.
In the last 5 years, have you been into a guy that you knew it would break the rules because you really like this guy? Or you can all explore whatever you want. Last question about this.
No. And you're welcome to. You can honestly
No, it's really the last question I have. Otherwise, I feel
bulletproof.
I'm exhausting it. But you're really that cool and collective, and I'm a little stuck up, I guess.
Yeah, no, right? I don't. I have no alpha issues.
You never went like, man, I'm falling for this guy, and Noah shouldn't know about it.
I will never fall for someone the way I know I love Noah.
Mm. It's interesting.
I'll never. Because
that wasn't really the answer.
But that is the answer.
Okay.
I love him like family.
You ever lusted for somebody and got nervous about it?
No, I don't get nervous about lust. I'll act on lust like that.
You're so funny. I'd love to see you together.
What, me and Noah?
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, he, poor thing. My poor partner. Shot?
Yeah, shot.
Why poor partner? Gone.
Yeah.
Why poor partner?
What?
Why poor partner?
Why poor partner?
You said, oh, Noah, poor partner.
Oh, because he's, you know, like, I'm a hyper extrovert. I have a very...
Your best friend is who?
Who is my best friend?
Who is your best friend other than your husband, boyfriend?
Oof. Noah probably isn't my best friend.
Right. Oof. Is that a shame?
What?
Is that a shame? Your husband's not your boyfriend. Or best friend. Or best friend.
No, he is my best friend.
I get you.
But
you know what I mean?
He's not my best friend.
He's not the one you just... Right. I'm going to get fucking nasty.
Keith, how long your current closest friends, how long have they been in your life?
I'm in a 15 years.
One of my best friends has been in my life for 30 years.
Okay.
Another one of my best friends has been in my life for 25 years.
All right.
The other ones have been around for over 20 years. I have very, very close long-term friendships.
Does Noah get jealous of them?
No, he's probably grateful that I have
get out of here.
No, because he hears me like screaming with my like queen friend.
My
Ryan
wife's like that.
On the phone.
Go see Adam. It's been too long.
Like, she's thrilled. Like they're all thrilled that we have these other people in our lives. To your good health.
Let's drink this poison to our great health.
To our great health.
Rosa.
Mm-hmm. One of my best friends.
How long do you know her?
Over 3 years, like three
over
to four
three.
Years.
Over 3 years? Well, she doesn't even make
three
the
to four
cut.
Years.
I thought you guys were close.
No. She was
bye, Rosa.
She was my upstairs neighbor. I love Rosa. She is genuinely one of my best friends.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Genuinely.
Her and Danny, what do we think? Let's be honest.
You know how I felt about it in the beginning.
The way you say it, probably you didn't get it, but I don't remember.
Do you not know about this?
No.
Okay. So Rosa and I, Mike Kaplan. It goes back. Mike Kaplan told me to come here and record a demo for a podcast.
Okay.
And he
for
arranged,
him or what?
No, for me.
Oh, okay.
And he had arranged for it.
That's
after
funny.
I
wait, right here?
Yes. And you were annoyed.
I did not know
you
about
were,
this.
No, you did know about it. And you were annoyed back then. This is 2 years ago.
No, but I must have not known about it ahead of time.
No,
and
I guess
why I
was
annoyed
then. And Mike was like, Keith, like, Danny's going to be there.
Right.
Come in and just record it after you record my podcast with me.
Right.
Rosa was my guest on that. And it was supposed to be this sort of antagonistic. I was going to antagonize a scientist.
Okay.
And Danny was a sound mixer. After it was over, I took Danny and Rosa out for burgers at that Bear Burger. Is that the place that's near here? I took them to Bear Burger and we had dinner. And then we went to my friend Ryan's house for cocktails. Rosa and Danny instantly
clicked.
Instantly were super into each other.
Okay.
And then Rosa went home with Danny and fucked him on his mattress on the floor.
Right.
Or whatever.
Right, right.
Then the next day was Danny's birthday or your birthday. It was somewhat, okay. I think it was Danny's birthday. And you were interviewing Danny on air.
Okay.
And you grilled him on the girl he banged the night before.
Okay.
And he revealed all the details of him fucking Rosa.
Right.
And...
I do remember.
I got really protective of Rosa because Rosa is an academic. Right. And I didn't want her to...
Her political career to be ruined.
Because she's in this like super weird academic program. I don't know if you knew, but like there was a girl who was in her program and they like showed a picture of her in like cargo shorts being like girls need to dress less suggestively for the workplace. I just couldn't have her, this dear friend of mine... who I brought to this thing, all of a sudden being treated as like this like pussy piece. Does that make any sense?
It makes sense, but how dare, like all this shit that I'm asking you simple sex questions. You're like, what? Why would that be? Blah, 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 blah. And then, it's like, I have to take care of this girl. And is she okay?
But you and Danny have this like boy talk about
that. We so do. We're such men.
You are men.
We fist pump daily. We can't quit fist pumping. We're like, bro, I swear to God, if there's like, it was against the law to say,
I want the record to show.
We would be arrested.
I've never been more drawn to a man than I am to you. I've never in my life.
But you're being silly.
I am silly. I just wanted
to
protect Rosa's.
And then do you say something to her? Like, hey.
Oh, no. I said something to you. I said something to you, like Brenda and Danny.
I forget what.
Like, that was not okay.
Oh, okay. What did I say? Okay, very good.
Oh, we never get. I never heard back from you, Danny.
Oh, you texted? Did you text?
Oh, it wasn't text. I
emailed. There's only three things.
It might have been email. It might have been email.
Oh,
and I was like, unacceptable.
Yeah.
Like this is a person. You can't just talk about her.
Did we play a cool next time Messiah? Because I don't remember.
No, the thing was, I took it so seriously, and then Rosa and Danny like actually fell in love.
Yeah.
Right? Like, so I was like protecting this girl who like was balls deep.
But isn't it so funny? Like you love her. You knew her for 3 years.
Yeah.
She's obviously smart, right?
Super smart.
And Danny does not look like a guy that's just conquering worlds, let's say. Do you know what I mean?
I just didn't.
In the bro way that you're talking about.
I thought you might have broed it. I thought that you might have made it
I bro-ier. Said, Danny, fuck. I mean, you need to fuck her. You go to this. I can't picture.
But it could be like, did you fuck her? Did you fuck her on your dirty mattress?
I can't picture. What? Okay. Then after the fact, who gives a fuck? But we're talking about like, I set it up and I was like, Danny, tonight, you fucking give it to her. You're allowed 3 puns only. And you stick it in, and tomorrow we talk, and how we talk is up to what you did.
Yeah.
Get the fuck out.
I just didn't want the situation to make it look like Rosa was
a slut.
Or used in any way, or a prop for, you know,
humor.
Dudes to talk about. You know what I mean? I didn't want that to happen.
Right. And you were on the show before that, right?
I had been on the show
once. How dare you? How dare you?
I know.
How dare you?
I know.
And you may now apologize.
I am. Well.
Huh?
I'm not. No. Because what if she.
That's weird.
What if they didn't fall in love, Keith?
And she's still. But she did.
They did.
And I was
fine.
They
very much fell in love.
So, good.
All right.
Good.
I love you.
Right. But you're apologizing.
I'm.
For what? What are you sorry for?
I'm not. I don't know that I am sorry.
You're not.
I think I did the right thing by being protective of a friend.
Right. Just by thinking it and driving people crazy. And then it all worked out.
I drove no one crazy.
If I would have read you this email, I would have said you. Because I'm not going to read your email. I'm going to forward it to Henda. I give a shit about a fucking date with Danny and some new guy's friend.
When did you and Danny almost make out?
Gives a fuck. Never. Never. Oh, that kiss is going to haunt you for life. All right, we're going to take a break. Here's Drops of Jupiter, his favorite song.
Oh, my God.
I got a pin.
It's literally fun.
Now that she's back in the atmosphere with drops of Jupiter in her head, she acts like summer and walks like rain. Reminds me that there's a time to change.
So, what's your name again, real quick?
Mehran.
So Mehran was saying, it was a power play. It's like how I lowered your seat inch.
Do you think it had any impact?
So Mehran said, I can be a downer or whatever. And then I'm like, all right, let's go back on the air.
Well, no, it's not that I can be a downer. It's I love tragic noises.
Tragic, I meant. Sorry. Yeah, tragic.
Yeah, tragic noises. I love them.
Do you like the idea? I remember, and it seemed like they, in the news, they put out something. And by news, I mean some Twitter feed I saw. Where George Carlin, you never heard this before, and now it's released, something about 9/11. The way I understood it, because I asked somebody who saw it, and I was right, and I think it's already out. But anyway, George Carlin said, I love destruction, I want everything to blow up, blah, blah, blah.
Uh-huh.
9/11 happened, okay. He never talked about it again, and I was like, well, I get it, but yeah, you really didn't think it would happen here, and tornadoes were safe, and this thing was safe. You know what I mean?
I'm listening.
Do you, if Trump makes it, is that fun? When things blow up and nobody that dies, is that fun?
Oh, God. I mean, I have an actual background with war.
Go on.
I was in Iran during the height of the Iran-Iraq war. I've seen.
Right. How did we do?
We did poorly. We saw body parts. We saw buildings blow up. We had our dads jump on us to save us from breaking glass.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
what's the thing? Do you still have dreams about it?
No.
Okay. How old were you?
I was 9 and 10. And 10. I came back to America when I was 11.
Okay. Do you meet some of your relatives and you're like, you're telling me a story that didn't really happen? Like they're like, and I had to throw your body out a window to another.
No. We had relatives executed. We lost family.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, absolutely. We lost, people disappeared. It was an actual revolution. So when I hear about people toughing it in America, I mean, I kind of do put my, you know, my
toughing chin, it like McNally.
My chin on my fist. You know what I mean? It's like, tell me more about your hardships. You know, tell me more about your struggle. Tell me about how you're afraid of black people. Tell me all about it. Do you know what I mean? Like, right. I love it. I love
But could you,
about
can you appreciate, am
petty
I misunderstand?
Suffering.
But is Black Lives Matter petty suffering?
No, Black Lives Matter is a legitimate cause.
Right, just checking.
No, Black Lives Matter is a very, very.
Why do you hate Roseanne Barr?
What is wrong?
Why do you hate Roseanne Barr?
What is wrong with you,
This
Keith?
Is how the show works. Welcome to it.
Keith, what is wrong with you? I don't hate Roseanne Barr.
I love
her very much, actually.
Okay. Okay.
But
so okay.
We had had a beef.
Okay.
Before Last Comic Standing, you're doing this to me.
What
it's
happened?
So bizarre that you're, who gave you this?
What happened?
Who gave you this?
Don't you shut your fucking mouth. I will tell you who gave me this. You tell me.
Uh-huh.
What fucking idiot that has not been on my show says I fake drink and fuck my guests? How dare you say I fuck my guests?
I never said you fucked your guests.
No, your friend did.
If
said I,
I would
fake
have done this
drink.
2 months ago if I found out you fucked your guests.
Oh, you shut your mouth. You shut your fucking mouth. You know what I mean? So, no, I'm not going to tell you until you tell me who told you I fake drink.
I'm not telling you anything.
I'm not telling you anything. Great. So, you and Roseanne Barr, what?
So fucked up. So it was the Oscars.
Can you imagine the one cigarette Mehran has in life?
Is what? The person
is
that...
this douche. I wonder if there's even
protect,
a person.
I always
is there even
sources.
A fucking person? Did you make up this whole
sources.
Fucking thing?
All I do is protect
Did
my
you
sources.
Make this up? Yes or no?
If I...
Say no. Did you make this up? Yes or no? You
yes.
made this fucking
yes.
thing up.
Yes. Yes. I made it up.
I think you did.
Yeah.
And I hope you live with even that this lie. One lie you have to live with. All right. Anyway.
Roseanne. So Quvenzhan Wallis.
Go on.
Was nominated for Beasts of the Southern Wild.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, right. The
for
kid. And then you tweeted something, right?
Mm-hmm. And The Onion tweeted, say what you will about Quvenzhan Wallis,
right.
but she's a fucking massive cunt. Or whatever it is that
yeah,
they
yeah,
said.
Yeah.
They said something to that effect.
Thought it was very funny.
And the moms of the world.
Yeah.
You know, they united and they sort of co-tweeted this like big mm-hmm. old,
of
you
course.
Know, how dare
how
you,
young
she's 11
woman?
And right. why would you do that? Yeah,
because I mean it. Like they expected somebody to write back through letters. Wouldn't that be funny? Letter, that's how you do a
post.
Thing.
The
you,
post.
You make letters in the mail
mm-hmm.
and we all mass mail. One person.
It would be like
and
Hogwarts
be like,
acceptances delivered by, yeah.
Yeah, that'd be great. And it'd be like, well, here's why I think she is a cunt.
Yeah.
And you just make an honest letter.
For the record, I like the way Hollywood starlets are indulged, there's no doubt in my mind she's a cunt. Like compared to her peers from her age group, I'm sure she's a wretched, entitled,
right.
awful person.
I would like to be clear. I mean, 100%. I don't think she is. We're just attacking
oh, I'm
these stupid idiots.
Positive
but,
she's a cunt.
But
I
that
saw
does
Annie,
make sense.
And I can smell I can smell an awful person.
Did you see Annie after the credits?
What do you mean? What
she
happened?
Gives the finger to the fucking...
No, she doesn't.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
she doesn't.
Yeah.
You're making that up.
It's a hard knock.
You
fuck you.
Love,
yeah.
You love after credits.
I love it. I watch everything. Nobody can tell me what's
just
going on.
Just wait until the bitter end, the end of a movie. I love you. I've become I love you drunk with Keith. But no, so then Roseanne sided with the moms who were like, you can't make fun of an 11-year-old.
Right.
And then I wrote her and I was like, bitch, are you serious? Like, you're the national anthem destroyer. You're the
crotch grabber spitting.
Like, are you
I
really?
Made fun, yeah.
Here's this satire.
Is
online
she, was
media
she
outlet.
Getting too legitimized with that fucking
it,
show?
It's not like I was calling, I wasn't saying like she had right. gone straight. I was just saying that's like a.
You like to take straight men,
uh-huh.
getting them drunk helps,
nope.
and blow them. There's a power position in it. True or false?
Well, I mean, I do like breaking a horse, don't I?
Yes.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
You love it.
I love
it. And I love it because these guys obviously aren't straight.
Well, no, what is straight?
Keith? Me. Mm. I like...
We made out, like...
Yeah, I would like.
Ago.
I would like to be clear. If a chick told me, it. If a chick told me we made out, I'd be like, yeah, let's make out a different way because I really want to make out.
What does that mean?
Make out means tongue. How old are you?
I don't know.
Do you not know? Because
no,
I wrote
don't.
It down. You're 40. That's why I start the show with age, height, and weight.
The worst. Do you do that with all your guests?
Yeah.
Do I you have, really start with age, height, and
yeah,
weight?
Yeah, because everything has to... It's your sex. It's how you have sex. It's your age. It's your height. It's your weight. And... Location
I think
and where you
honest.
Move to.
I agree with
and
you.
And that's it. Fucking seven questions.
I agree with you 100%, Keith.
I should call the show Seven Questions.
Yeah, no, it should be called What Do You Weigh?
What
is it? Should be
called. And then, and you know what?
Or,
honest
or
to God.
Hey, fatty.
The guest would still be surprised when I said, now, what do you weigh?
Yeah.
Like, really?
Like, are we actually doing this? Have you done that to other people? I've watched a handful of these, and I think I'm the first person you've asked what they
no,
weigh.
No, of course I do. I ask women it. Yeah.
Do you really?
I showed you promos. Yeah. Of course I
didn't I
do.
See you ask anyone in those promos. Because
those are promos. Those are polite.
Yeah, well, but you could have told me that you were going to ask me what I weighed.
I did before the show.
No, you didn't.
Somehow it came out because
no, we
were
bought ice. We bought booze. Right. We went on a few field trips.
I think I did. But anyway, Were you always overbearing?
Fat?
Not even fat, but yeah, it has to do with it. Overbearing, where you couldn't get picked on because people were nervous, you would just punch them.
A little.
Did it feel good? Because I kind of would love it. My bully was a big fatso who was just like, and I didn't know to do it. Like you said earlier, we all need to learn to fucking punch back.
That's right.
But where were you at?
There was one kid in my entire high school experience, two kids in my entire high school experience, who had the nuts to do it to my face. But the problem
to
is...
To do what?
To say anything to my face.
See? That's what I mean. So you... They said it all to my face. They were almost literal nuts to my face.
Lucky you. I would have loved nuts to my face. I was praying nightly for nuts to my face. You have no idea.
You can't always get what you want.
It really is. But you get what you need. And that's a teabagging anthem. You get what you need. I wanted it so much. You don't, you know, it's not every day.
But a guy comes up to you.
Mm-hmm.
He has the balls to come up to you. What happened?
A giant black athlete in my high school.
And what did he do?
He didn't even say anything. He just smacked me.
Like slapped you or punched?
No,
slapped. What's that mean? What like smacked? Slap.
Open hand slap.
Yeah, in the face.
Mm-hmm.
And then what?
He turned around and walked.
And there was no beginning or end.
His life is in ruin. I mean, like the number of ghosts I've sent after him is unbelievable.
But no joke. Like he.
That was it. That was the whole thing.
He walked up to you.
Mm-hmm.
You promise?
I swear to God, in the hall.
And just slapped
said
you and
nothing.
Left.
Said nothing.
So now you must wonder what happens. You look down the hall. Are other kids watching? Like that was a
no,
dare?
No, it was like, it was so instantaneous. It was like, it was a second and then he walked away.
What's his name?
Rashad Wilson.
Rashad Wilson.
Mm-hmm.
Did you look him up? Because I look up old high school.
No.
People. No? No, why? Gives him satisfaction? Because
no,
I am so fucking curious.
No, because I'm fairly sure he's not a person of import.
But isn't it funny? But that's the good news. You hope he's not a person of import.
No, I mean, I'm sure of it. I haven't heard anything about him.
Well, how would we? How would we know about somebody that slapped us in the face in high school?
Amanda Palmer. I went to high school with her. I went to
Amanda Palmer was a bitch to you?
No, Amanda Palmer and I were very good friends.
Right, so that's what I mean.
I know about Eugene Merman. We went to high school together.
But you like
Pete Holmes.
You like these people. You like these people enough, right? Huh?
I don't...
Were they mean to you?
Amanda has had moments of cruelty.
What happened? How?
We're old friends.
How are women cool?
We're old friends. That's
so,
how it
I don't
works.
Know what that means. Honest to God, I'll tell you, my best friend is, let's say, Adam Brown.
Okay.
We had a fight once.
Do you have old friends who have become famous?
No.
Okay.
No. No. They were, I have friends that like, but through Keith and the girl, we're like, I see them and then they get famous,
mm-hmm.
But not like, you know, kids I grew up with, like you're saying.
Mm.
So, what's my point? Oh, me and Adam, we had some stupid little fight. What did you just do?
I got sexy with the microphone.
I didn't know if you licked your lip and then touched
no,
it.
No, I got excited about this.
Oh, okay.
Thin membrane.
Right. Between... To get through the barrier,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
All right. I still think you're 100% gay, but it is fun to get through that little piece, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, we had some stupid fight in our apartment. Anyway, does it matter? Do you want to hear it?
No, I do want to hear it, but can I ask you a question?
You can ask me two questions.
Okay. The first question is, when you interview people on My Name is Keith,
yeah.
Do you normally feel very much in control?
No, we're drunk. No,
okay,
obviously
right.
I don't.
So you're drunk with them.
Yeah.
But I feel like...
Well, you saw me drinking.
Yeah, but people get carted out of here. Like,
I want everybody to know. You saw me pour this, right?
I did.
Okay.
Well, you don't have to do that. Not for me.
No, I enjoyed it.
I did too. And we've had 8 shots altogether so far.
Okay.
So
what's the question?
I don't know. I don't feel as vulnerable as I do when I do Keith and the girl. And I normally feel very vulnerable, especially to you.
Thank you.
Especially to you.
Because you have a guard up then.
Right? I don't have a guard up then.
So what are you saying?
It's that
we're just having fun.
Now we're just having fun. But I've never met you as a peer. I've always met you as a control figure, as an authority figure.
Shame on you.
Why? What does that mean?
Because back on Keith and the Girl, why would I be a control figure?
Because this is your gig. This is you what you do. You're very good
on.
At it.
Thank
you're very,
you.
Very good
Thank
at
you.
It.
Thank you. Is there any interest and having Danny Hatch blowing you?
No.
The sexy part
no.
is that Rosa happens to be your friend. Would that be sexy and blowing?
That's not sexy for me.
Why?
Because Rosa is permissive and Danny is hideous.
Okay, very good.
That's awful. That's an awful.
Beef with Roseanne Barr, check.
Yeah.
By the way, this is how far we got.
What do you mean? No, but just for the record, the Roseanne thing, I really had to work very hard to fix it.
I don't even know what it is, though.
It's that so she defended Quvenzhan Wallis, and I was like, bitch, are you serious?
Right.
And she was like, don't you, like, yes, I am serious, and don't you talk
about how far, is it a back and forth Twitter? What's this
beef? Yeah, it was back and forth Twitter, and then Roseanne was like, yes, I am serious. Don't you mansplain anything to me.
Is it kind of fun doing that? Going like, this is
at
Roseanne
the time,
Barr.
At the time, it was hella fun.
When's then, it not fun?
Then I'm on Last Comic Standing and she's my judge.
Oh, shit. Does she remember though? She's so dopey.
She doesn't remember because she blocks like 40 people a day.
Yeah.
She really does.
Okay.
She's
agree.
She's very active on Twitter. She says a lot of
I hated everyone
things.
On that show because the show's so dumb. With these judges,
okay,
honestly,
loved it unedited.
Hold on 1 second. Oh, I would have, but like, this is just in the positive way drives me crazy. I have never heard anything like this, and I'm talking all three judges, Damon Wayans, the other one.
Yeah,
this is refreshing and the best thing. What the fuck?
Am I not refreshing in the best way?
There's not fireworks out there, asshole. In the end. It's three great jokes. You love them or you don't.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's right. The issue came up when I was supposed to interact with them on social media after the fact, but Roseanne had blocked me.
Oh, wow.
Because of the Quvenzhan Wallis thing.
Get the
Eventually,
fuck
she
out.
Was like, she said something to the effect of, I hope they bomb Iran and yakety yak. It was a fucking disaster.
She's insane.
Well, she's mentally ill.
She thought she could be president.
And she needs behavioral health support. I need behavioral health support. That dude you played.
When do you go to therapy?
I don't go to therapy anymore.
Interesting. So everybody needs it. You don't.
No. I've been
when
to.
When you left.
How many years of therapy have
17.
I had? Close.
Yeah, I know.
Close.
Yeah.
Close.
14.
Something around that.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just not in therapy now because I went to a therapist in New York and she didn't speak English. I went to a Chinese therapist.
And that was the best.
And she was like, oh, I didn't understand anything you said for the last 6 months. Like, literally, that's how she was. I'm not being racist. That's how Chinese she was.
It would be funny if you go, I gotta be honest, you were the best fucking therapist
I
ever
sometimes had. She was. Sometimes I would go in there and she'd be like, play with these toys. And I would just go and play with toys. And I would be like, Jesus, I guess I do feel better.
What's the crying breakthrough? Me no.
Like, she was that. Her notes were in Chinese. I couldn't read them. It was all very nervous. And so I stopped going to her.
Anyway.
Yeah, no. I mean, it was.
You were great.
It was.
You
it
were
was.
Great.
Yeah, so I stopped going to the one therapist in my neighborhood.
You love to turn over straight men. Or you used to.
I used to.
Okay.
Yeah.
You also love to turn over soldiers. Because those are the manliest of men.
Yeah, I used to get into fights with soldiers and I would like to bed them. Yes, true.
So how would it start? They hear you, they don't like you at first, and then there's some fight like you're gay?
No, I'd find out that someone was a soldier.
Right.
And then I would...
In regular clothes,
In regular clothes.
Okay.
And then I would drink with them.
Right.
And then I would over-drink with them.
Okay.
And then
knowing you can drink more?
Knowing I can outpace them.
And I'll get to that later. So you're drinking knowing you can outpace them. Yeah, I'll pace them.
Mm-hmm.
And then what do? You find out they're gay?
No, and then I would be like, let's go to my place.
And they go, yeah. So then you know they are gay though, right? Or they really never, or am I taking some away from you?
Isn't everyone gay? A little bit, Keith.
I'm not a little bit.
I bet you are.
Well, that's sweet.
No, but I'm not, and I don't mean that.
If you jerk off to me tonight, that would be fun to me.
That, and it might happen.
It should happen. It should happen.
It won't happen until you give me something else.
Well, it won't because I have this attitude.
No. But I need something more.
I can't give any more. I'm married.
It's not.
But you know what I'm saying. So these guys, you talk to these guys. So what do? You bring them back to your place? Because at that point, they know then.
Oh, no,
they
no.
obviously know you're gay. No.
By the time I've seduced them utterly. This is back when I was
5 years ago?
No.
10 years ago?
15.
15.
Yeah.
30 years old.
I was 25.
25.
I was 25. And I would find like a 40-year-old soldier. And he would be a certain way. And I would be like, and I was the most.
Did you live by a camp?
I was in Miami.
Okay.
So if they're in Miami, if they're drunk in a bar, and right. I looked the way that I did, it was a done deal.
Because they knew. They're talking to you for a reason.
Right? To an extent, probably.
Okay.
To an extent, probably. I think that's an astute observation.
Well,
yeah.
I like what I like. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
I like what I like. And isn't sex only fun when it's what's not supposed to be happening?
No. I get what you're saying. Dirty sex or sex that shouldn't be happening is so very fun.
It's so very fun.
But I do like sex that is also
expected. Right. No harm, no foul sex. Is that what you mean? Yes, that can also be fun. Jizzing is unequivocally fun.
I think we got somewhere.
Yeah, I mean, like, just coming for cum's sake is also fun. I don't feel guilty about masturbating. Yeah. I'm not one of those.
But do you miss that to that point?
No, it's like there's a season for things, right?
No, what does that mean? Because you were young, you
it
mean?
Means, it means that when I was 25.
But you're older than that. You have the
when
same
I was
fucking
25
thoughts.
And irresistible.
When I was young, I liked hot chicks. Now, I guess I don't like hot chicks?
No, I have no interest. I wouldn't suffer people who aren't...
It would be funny you ask your guy, like, hey, can I just fucking trick a soldier for a second?
I just realized I was lying.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
I realized
appreciate
I was lying.
It. That's a drink.
Yeah.
And I appreciate your honesty.
Yeah. I realized I was lying.
How do we do this?
Here it is.
There we go. Thank you. What's the truth?
The truth is I don't lament not having that as an active part of my life right now because I have had it in droves at another chapter of my life.
Right. Would you marry him?
Huh?
Will you marry him?
My man?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why not?
Why not yet?
Yeah.
Weddings are expensive and it's stupid.
You can just get married in City Hall. Why not put your name to it? Like it's like voting, right?
No,
you're just
I need
putting
him
your name
to
something.
The legitimate face of our operation. My credit is garbage. I have lived,
Is he not willing to? Does that scare him?
No. He's very willing to.
Okay. What's the problem?
Why do that?
Why not do it? I get why
do it.
What does
it cost to get married?
Nothing.
It does not cost nothing.
$25. No joke. You're filling out some form.
Yeah.
I'll marry you.
You can't. You're married.
I really can marry you.
Oh,
not,
is it
not
like,
I will marry you.
I also married a couple
but
recently.
I did just blow your mind.
I also,
yeah.
Solemnized.
Boom.
A couple.
Solemnized?
Solemnized.
Okay. I marry people. I didn't even know that was a word.
Solemnization is what you're... Actually, when you sign any wedding certificate, it says solemnizer.
Okay. All right. Don't tell people I didn't know it.
Yeah, great.
All right. But I'm a minister. I'm not going to lie to you.
Yeah.
I like you.
I like you too.
Now get the fuck out.
All right. I'm out.
My name is Keith! best show ever. Day.